Hi everybody. Today I am doing a rice dish which is called tahiri, and tahiri is actually for somebody who doesn't like meat or doesn't eat meat. And this is very very popular in the north, in most of the households on weekends, afternoon people just do this. This is kind of an brunch that people eat on a Sunday in India. So I'm going to do show you as to how I do tahiri. In this plate, I'll start showing you as to what I have. I've sliced one onion here, which is white onion. You can use any onion again, pink or red, whatever that you have in your cupboard. Then here I have about half a teaspoon of fennel seeds that I have kind of semi-crushed. Next to it, I have about another 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, which is zeera in Hindi. Then I have 2 whole red chilies that I've broken into half. About half a teaspoon here I have of coriander seeds that I've again crushed. And I've kind of semi-crushed, so it's like really not powder, but I've kind of just broken it. So okay, so next to it then I have a cinnamon stick, 3 cloves and 1 black cardamom. I have 3 green cardamoms that I have actually opened up so that they release the aroma and the flavor. Then I have 2 bay leaves here. One is slightly bigger than the other one, so about 2 bay leaves. This is the whole spices that I'm going to be using. And then I have in this bowl, I've taken about 2 small potatoes that I have peeled and cubed them like this. And I've dipped them in cold water so that they don't discolor. In this, I have about a handful of cabbage that I've sliced. Then I have green peas here. This is about 4 tablespoons of fresh green peas. I'm using frozen one today, the frozen peas I'm using today. Then I have about 1 big tomato that I finely chopped. I have cauliflower here that this is like basically 1 flower that I've taken from the entire bunch, and I have sliced it like this. Then I have 1 carrot that I have again chopped like this, and I have 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste. Then I'm going to be using some powdered spices also that I'm going to show you while I add them in the rice. So let's get started. I'm going to keep this aside, move the camera a little in front, I think. Yes, and I normally do this rice in kadhai, but if you want, you can also use a heavy bottom pan, a pot actually, not a pan, a heavy bottom pot. So I'm going to switch on the flame now, and I'm going to add some vegetable oil. You can use any oil that you prefer, but I'm using vegetable oil for this in my tahiri. You can use any vegetable that you like, but not vegetables that are very watery, like not your courgettes and not your lauki and things like that, you know. But if you don't like peas, you can skip peas. If you don't want to add cauliflower, you can skip cauliflower. You can just do this with potato or whatever vegetable that you like. So you can use any vegetable that you like. Now here I've taken about 4 tablespoons of oil in this kadhai that I'm using today, and I'll wait for about 30 odd seconds for it to heat up. Okay, so now to this I'm going to add my whole spices, which is cumin, bay leaves, fennel seeds, broken red chilies, coriander seeds, clove, cardamom, everything together. And give it a little mix. And now at this stage I'm going to add the onions as well. And we have to fry the onions till they're like brown in color. And this is on high flame, guys. Make sure that you keep mixing everything when you're doing this, so that you know your spices are like equally distributed, they don't get burnt, and the onions really don't take much time to caramelize. So you can see the onions have kind of started becoming light brown now from the sides. Okay, so you can see the onions are nice and brown in color. I'm going to add the tomatoes. And give it a little mix. And I'm going to add ginger garlic paste also to it now. Okay, now I'm adding the powdered spices. So here I have coriander powder. I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of coriander powder. One teaspoon of paprika powder. And about 4 to 5 pinches of red chili powder. Then I have haldi, which is turmeric. So I'm going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, a little more actually. Say about 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. And now I'm going to add garam masala. Now this is homemade garam masala. I'm adding about 1 teaspoon of garam masala to this. I'm going to reduce the flame and I'll start adding all the vegetables one by one. So I've added the cauliflower, the carrots and the cabbage, peas and now the potatoes. Give it a mix. Okay, and now for this I'm going to add some hot water. Just about 6 tablespoons of water that I've added to this. And the last bit is the salt. So I'm just adding about 1 teaspoon of salt here at this stage. Minimum, and I'm going to cover this and let the vegetables cook at least 50%, and then I'll show you what needs to be done next. So I'll see you in about 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, I will now lift . Okay, so this is how the vegetables are looking now. They're nicely cooked. And I had chopped some fresh coriander, so I'm going to add coriander, good amount of coriander to this. Give it a mix. And here I have 1 cup soaked rice in hot water, so I'm going to add this along with the water. Gently give it a mix. I'll tell you how I measure the water in the rice. Let me wipe my hands. It's actually till here. So this mark of the first finger, the second mark of the first finger, the rice should be, the water should be coming to that level. So just still a little less. I'm going to add some more water. Okay, so it is almost there. You can see the mark has to be till here. The water should come to this level. The first finger, second mark. I'm going to add some more salt to this because I've added rice now. So I'm adding about 1.5 teaspoon of salt more to this. And I'll cover it and I'll increase the flame to maximum. Wait for 1 boil to come and then I'll lower the flame to minimum and let it cook for about 10 to 12 minutes. So I'll show you when the boil comes and then I'll reduce the flame. Thank you. check if the boil has come. You can see the boil has started to come, but I'll let a nice one boil come and then close the lid and lower the flame, sorry. Oh, it's coming nice. It takes about good 5 minutes, though I've used hot water, but even then it takes about good 4 to 5 minutes for a complete nice boil to come. So we just need to wait till then and then lower the flame to minimum and then let it cook for about 10 to 12 minutes. Hey, if you can see, there's nice boil that has come now. And I am now going to lower the flame to minimum and then let it cook for about 10 to 12 minutes. Come back and show you the final result before I start serving this. Okay, so I think the rice is done now. I'll just lift the lid and see how the rice is looking. If you can see that there's small holes in the rice now, that means it's completely cooked and there's no water in left now at all in the rice. I'm going to switch off the flame and cover it and let it rest for about 5 to 7 minutes and then mix it. I'll open it again to show you how the rice is looking. So this is actually how I do my this particular recipe, which is called tehri in Hindi. And it's a mixed vegetable rice, basically. Absolutely amazingly delicious. Must try it with mixed vegetable raita, some papadums. And if you have a dry vegetable that has a lot of masala, it is excellent with it. So I'm going to cover it now and let it rest for about 5 to 7 minutes before I mix it and I serve it. Thank you for watching today. If you've liked this recipe, what I've done, please go and click on the like button, share it with as many people as you can, with all your friends and family, and do leave a comment if you want me to do something in specific next time for you. Thank you again. Bye bye.